The U.S. got ready for war against North Korea in 1994. Recently declassified reports distributed on Friday have uncovered. The organization of then-U.S. President Bill Clinton trusted that the U.S. military and South Korea's powers would without a doubt win a contention on the isolated Korean promontory, yet in addition comprehended the quantity of losses would be colossal. The war designs came as the U.S. was arranging North Korea's atomic demilitarization. Resistance Secretary William Perry revealed to South Korean President Kim Dae-jung at the time. "Of course, with the consolidated powers of the ROK and U.S., we can without a doubt win the war, yet war includes numerous setbacks simultaneously," RT reports. The U.S. made its arrangement for war as North Korea started defilling a reactor that could give fissile material to atomic bombs, creeping nearer towards building up discouragement against the U.S. and its partners who have long tried to topple the legislature in Pyongyang. The recently discharged reports additionally uncover that in 1997, Washington stressed that a starving North Korea – experiencing interminable nourishment deficiencies and underapprovals – could turn into a perilously clamorous circumstance. This educated the U.S. way to deal with the four-party talks, including the U.S., China, South Korea and North Korea, which must be sufficiently adaptable to envelop an extensive variety of alternatives, from a crumple of the North to significant changes which would give the DPRK administration recharged essentialness. North Korea has now settled its atomic weapons store, which would murder 2.1 million individuals and harm 8 million others should it be released on Seoul and Tokyo, as indicated by a current report. In November, North Korea asserted it propelled another sort of intercontinental ballistic rocket, the Hwasong-15, that could hit any objective on the U.S. terrain. U.S. and North Korean pioneers keep on trading points as strains increase. Trump has been called an old maniac and war-parched by North Korean state media, and the U.S. has been undermined to be lessened to powder and haziness. The U.S. president said Washington would thoroughly annihilate North Korea if assaulted, and that little rocket man, as he regularly calls Kim Jong-un, won't associate with any longer. In the interim, the U.S. and its local partners do enormous military activities reenacting the obliteration of North Korea. This week American and South Korean pilots rehearsed assaults on North Korea's atomic and rocket establishments in various war situations. A weekend ago, White House National Security Council H.R. McMaster cautioned the likelihood of war with Pyongyang is expanding each day. On Saturday, CIA boss Mike Pompeo said U.S. knowledge organizations trust the North Korean pioneer does not understand how frail his position is. "People around him are not encouraging him reality about the place that he gets himself, how tricky his position is on the planet today. It's most likely difficult to reveal to Kim Jong-un terrible news," he said at a Reagan Institute discussion in California. Pompeo's conviction was undermined, however, by a current proclamation from resigned Lieutenant General Jan Mark Juiz, the previous appointee administrator of U.S. powers in Korea. Juiz said that the 30,000 in number U.S. powers positioned in the neighboring South would battle to counter the North Korean army, which Pyongyang asserts right around 5 million individuals have volunteered for. Russia and China have proposed a twofold stop methodology, in which the U.S. stops its drills with South Korea in return for the North suspending its atomic weapons programs. The U.S. has repelled the proposition, be that as it may, saying it has each privilege to complete activities with its partners.